Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another Super Rugby Extra podcast with your hosts, Damien Warren and
Toby Harris.
Now, mates, our topic today is a very, very important topic. Is Eddie Jones a douchebag?
Yes. Now, this is actually quite a difficult one.
It really is a difficult one, isn't it?
Yeah. Because we obviously need to talk about why he's a douchebag and why he isn't.
Yes, because, I mean, it would be fair to say, okay, that I am torn between whether or not I think he's a douchebag or not. So we're going to dissect it tonight.
Okay.
Today for some people. And we're going to give you the fors and against that we can think of, and then we'll make a decision at the end. So shall we start off with examples of how he's not a douchebag?
Okay, you go first.
Okay, first thing that comes to my mind is this. He's very rarely out of work. Okay, so
he's obviously doing something right.
He's obviously doing something right. He, you know, when we talk about he ruffles people's feathers and all these different types of thing, to the people that really matter, he obviously does enough to keep them happy. And the other thing I would say is, he's going back to Japan, right? So if he was a proper douchebag or knobhead or whatever, I can't imagine they'd want him back.
Well, I think, you know, the Japan as a nation, they're very respectful, aren't they?
Yes.
You know, and they're all about sort of their values. And to some people, Steady Eddie doesn't have those values. You know, he will bring people in, he'll throw people out willy-nilly.
Oh, but, hang on. You're going into the negatives, mate.
But
don't go into the negatives. It's positives.
You're butting in again. Listen, okay? But they've brought him back, haven't they?
Correct.
You know? So he's obviously doing something right for them. Okay. And he's replaced a very good coach.
Yes, and Jamie Joseph.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a big one for me. He's never out of work, and he's gone back to Australia. And he's gone back to Japan, which means both those countries knew what they were getting, but still wanted him. Okay. The second thing is he's got mates. Eddie Jones has mates. All right.
Now, yeah, big time.
If he's got mates, he can't be that bad, can he?
He knows the right people in the right places.
You know, we're talking about Steve Hansen as a big mate of his.
Yeah.
Okay. Lots of leaguey friends. You know, he's in there with the NRL guys.
He's a good coach. He's a good coach.
Yeah, so.
And if we look at what he's done with the teams, he's a good coach.
You know, you'll talk, ex-players talk very glowingly of him and say he was a harsh taskmaster. But on the whole, they have a lot of respect for him. I know James Haskell talks about the fact that he felt that Eddie Jones kind of saved his career and extended his career for a number of years, and they really liked him. I think a lot of players are scared of him, but yeah. So he's got mates. He's got people that speak highly of him.
Correct.
So that's another big one. Next up, I'm struggling.
I got nothing.
I'm struck. He's got a wife. He's got a wife. Okay.
Does
so
he?
He's found the love of his life. All right. He's married.
He's obviously doing something right then, isn't he?
So he's obviously doing something right. Yeah, that's about it. Okay. For me, anything that you want to add to that?
I've got nothing. Nothing.
Okay. Evidence that he is a douchebag.
Oof. I mean, you've you just need a look at them. Oh, I think just the way he talks to people, you know, like the media and things like that. I think sometimes he can go about things the wrong way.
Yeah, I think the biggest example of him being, you know, someone that you wouldn't want to buy a house off him.
No.
You know what I mean? Like, no. You know, I don't trust him.
Typical car salesman.
Car salesman. Is the Japan thing. You know, he's, you know, signs to coach for Australia through to the next World Cup. And before he leaves to go to the World Cup, he's actually already in conversations with Japan to become the next Japanese coach.
Agreed. Carry on.
No, you go. You go.
Yeah, and I think he's a journeyman, isn't he? He's a journeyman. We, Damien, you and I both know a journeyman, don't we?
And I look in the mirror, mate. I look in the mirror.
No. You know, we've worked with a journeyman, haven't we?
Oh, yes. We have. A number.
And, yep. And he's just one of them. He hops around and he's almost looking for the best offer.
Yeah. Yes. It's all about number one.
Yeah. And I know that maybe not with England, because I think he was forced out in a way. But he's gone from place to place quite quickly. Apart from his Australian and then his England job.
I would say that's another example about him. He can't be that bad, because he did stick with England for, I think, 6 or 7 years. And, you know, that was a long time for anyone to coach.
Yes.
Especially
the longest stint in England coaching.
Well, he's the most successful. I think you're right. I think he's the longest serving England coach and the most successful.
The most successful, yeah.
So, but here we go. This is a big one. One of the reasons why I think he must be a douchebag, a knobhead, is because the number of coaches who he coaches with who leave very quickly after meeting him.
Okay. It would also be interesting to see how many players came and went under him.
Oh, a hell of a lot of players.
Yeah.
And that's another reason. He was very good at giving players a cap so that they then couldn't go and play for another country.
Correct.
And then never to play again. And that smells of a douchebag to me. Zach Mercer is a good example.
Yeah.
But there are many others.
Yeah.
That, you know, are Welsh qualified, Scottish qualified. He gives them a cap so that they can't go and play for their own country again. So that's another example. He's fearful is another, you know, like the players
almost
fear
a bit
him.
Of a dictator.
Yeah, dictator. Now, is there a good dictator? Is there?
haven't heard of a good dictator.
So is it that people are so scared to talk out about Eddie Jones is the reason why we don't hear about Eddie Jones and all the stories?
Yeah.
There is that John Mitchell story that I've heard, which was England were on a day off. All the players were away. And John Mitchell, his son, Daryl Mitchell, was playing in the cricket. And he was about to drive off to go and watch his son play, you know, his cricket match. And Eddie Jones was standing by the gate and went, "Where do you think you're going?" And John Mitchell went, "I'm off to see, you know, Daryl play in the
cricket.
He went, "No, you're not. And, you know, if you go, you've lost your job. So
he
obviously left and he didn't come back.
Brilliant.
That's not an example.
John.
Anyway, family comes first, eh?
Exactly.
Family comes first.
Exactly.
Mate, can you think of any other example? I mean, Harry talks to the media.
Yeah.
Is an example, which I like and I hate in the same breath.
Yeah.
But any more examples of why we should think that is he a douchebag, is he not a douchebag?
No, but I'm sure the listeners will let us know.
Okay. Now, I want to hear from you. Which side of the fence are you resting on?
Oh, douchebag.
Douchebag
truly.
Or
yeah,
not
two
douchebag?
Feet. 2 feet. Oh, I can't even see the fence.
Are you going to stay on the fence?
No, I can't even see it.
So, sorry, I missed that because you might have cut out. Are you douchebag or non-douchebag?
He's a douchebag. I've never liked him.
Okay. All right. I like this. I'm actually going to go the other way. Okay.
Oh, of course you are.
I'm going to say he's not a douchebag. I'm going to say he's incredibly competitive. And like a lot of people, that he sees red. And we often see him seeing red. So I think he's a bloody good bloke and a better guy for knowing. He does act like a douchebag a lot, but he's got mates. There's not a lot of people that talk openly badly about him. So I'm going to say he's not a douchebag.
Oh, okay. Agree to disagree. Hey?
Mate, thanks very much for another good potty. What can people do to support us?
Like, share, subscribe. They can 5-star review. How many 5-star reviews have we got? Have you checked on that lately?
Oh, I haven't checked recently, mate. I haven't checked recently.
Patreon, the link is below. They can message in, email in, and just listen. Just keep listening.
Keep listening. Mate, as always, love doing the potty with you. Till next week.
See you later.